It seems like you're always hearing about how just about everything gives you cancer. It's always something you constantly come in contact with. Then there might be some article saying the opposite. Cancer is really tricky, and there are still so many studies to be done. But there are some things that the scientific community is fairly confident about when it comes to cancer rates. What things cause them to be higher? Let's arm ourselves with knowledge and leg ourselves with smarts. Triangle Bob. Did you write that in the script? I told you, my computer is off limits. Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. Picture this, trillions of cells in your body, each housing around 20,000 genes within its DNA. It's a genetic extravaganza. And boy, is it crowded in here. These genes are the masterminds behind controlling cell functions. But when mutations strike, resulting in wacky proteins, chaos ensues. Cancer may emerge, turning cells into uncontrollable replicating machines. And this sounds like an action movie, but alas, it's real life. And super disappointing. Cancer sucks. But wait, what triggers these gene mutations, you ask? Good question, me pretending to be you. First up, we have germline mutations, the family heirlooms passed down from your parents. Quite rare, accounting for only 5 to 10% of cancer cases. The real party crashers are acquired or somatic mutations. These sneaky mutations can occur during DNA replication, adding an element of randomness into the mix. Studies suggest they can contribute to 10 to 30% of cancer cases. Now, let's unveil the culprits behind these genetic shenanigans, shall we? Your cells face all sorts of damage throughout life's grand adventure. Think UV radiation, tobacco, viruses, diet, inflammation, and even good old aging. It's like a cosmic game of whack-a-mole mutation. Keep in mind, cancer is a multi-step process. We're talking about several mutations before it takes center stage. That's why it often prefers a mature audience, older folks who have had more time for these genetic slip-ups to accumulate. While you can't exactly choose your genes or halt the clock, not yet at least, people are working on that, fear not, there's hope in avoiding cancer's more aggressive party invitations. Take tobacco, for instance. As cigarette sales boomed, lung cancer mortality rates skyrocketed. Studies even found that 87% of lung cancer deaths were caused by tobacco use. So when cigarette sales decreased, so did the number of lung cancer deaths. This could be accomplished with other types of cancer as well. For example, about 90% of non-melanoma skin cancer cases are caused by exposure to the sun's UV radiation, which can be avoided by staying out of the sun or wearing protective clothing or sunscreen. And over 95% of cervical cancer cases are caused by the human papillomavirus, which there are vaccines for. All these might sound scary, but these preventative measures can start right now. While risk can never be eradicated completely, we can minimize it by living healthy lives. Cancer, you better beware. There are a lot of really smart people figuring out how to stop you. Comment question time. So have you or anyone you know struggled with cancer? Any inspirational or heartfelt stories you'd like to share? If you're comfortable with doing so, share it right now in the comments below. Cancer is a tough subject, but other people might see your story and feel less alone. Click here to watch this video we did on how cancer could potentially meet its match, or click here to watch this video. If you want to support some great people trying to cure age-related diseases, check out the team that powers Life Noggin, lifespan.io, down in the description. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.